Now we are done with the cost cut, and let me just quickly take you to one thing that you'd be required to do in your day-to-day. Not day-to-day, I should say. You might get this type of assignment that find out. Just move me to the... This is known as break-even point. So this is the break-even point. Break-even point is the point. Actually, we call it break-even point, but actually whatever you find out is actually you find the point, but actually you find what you find out after deriving it is actually the output. So the unit in break-even point is the output, not price, not cost, not revenue, not year, not time, nothing. So it is the output. So it is a point when you are, it is a point where your total revenue equals your total cost. And the business is supposed to run on a no profit, no loss basis. Now, why do we need it? We need it because when you start a managed transport service, now you cannot expect that from day one it should give you a run on a profit. I mean, it may not be the case. It can be anything. It can be water supply. It can be anything, any damn thing, whatever, any civic services for which you can find out the cost and revenue. You should be in a possible to find out the cost and revenue. That is the basic assumption. If you say, sir, I cannot find out the cost and revenue and the price part, then to no point doing it. And there is no reason you should not be able to find out the all those components which are required to find out the break-even point. It is a point, break-even, we call it break-even because this is the point at which, where you want to go at least. That, okay, let me just go to the break-even. If I achieve the break-even, fine. After that, I shall improve my services or whatever I do so that my point goes beyond the break-even point, thereby meaning that I stand to earn profit. Now, the... dekhiye. It shows the amounts of goods needed to produce. So break-even point mein kuch fixed cost hai, kuch variable cost hai, and the formula for... So you need three things to find out the break-even point. One is the price of the product, one is the fixed cost, and one is the variable cost. Now, we know what is fixed cost, you know what is variable cost, you know what is price. Now, if you take say water, or if you take transport, or if you take what should I say, water ho gaya, transport, what more, what more can be, what are the service, you just tell me what service can you take into account. It could be solid waste management, it could be sewerage, it could be parking, it could be, what is this? What are those services? Environmental services, could bataiye. Readily not coming to me right now. So it can be any urban services which you can measure, for which there is a price, for which there is a cost. Cost both in terms of fixed cost as well as in terms of variable cost. So three things are needed to find out the break-even. Break-even what? Break-even output. So you are concerned with that what minimum ridership I must get in my operation of the fleets. If you're in charge of the transport department, actually, this is the minimum ridership that I might get. So this ridership is your production. If somebody is in charge of water, he or she may be asked to find out the break even. That is, what is the minimum level of water that must be produced, which would enable me to reach the break even. Break even does not mean loss. Break-even does not mean profit either. Now, in our system, in our urban system, if you can call it, most of the goods that we consider are usually regarded as merit good, or I won't call it public good always, but merit good, of course, merit good. Because a public good mein kuch public good has got some characteristics. It has you cannot exclude anybody. So non excludability something. You cannot exclude anybody. Then non rivalry. Then it is a natural monopoly. Then it is inefficient market. So these are some of the elements of a public good, but not all public good. I for one do not buy the idea that all civic services are public good. These are merit good. There is no doubt about it. But public good, I don't mind. Say for example, let me give you an example that what do you mean by non-excludability? Non-excludability means that you cannot exclude anybody from the benefit of the service. Now, maan lijiye abhi street light. Now, if you call street light a public good, now it is non-excludable in the sense that if you impose taxes, maan lijiye in your locality, the municipality has installed street lights. So you are very happy that all the roads get lit up in the evening and it looks so nice. Now, a municipality has imposed a tax, street light tax on it. Now, does it mean that if out of 100 odd people living in that locality, if 5 people don't pay or 10 people don't pay, the municipality will switch it off? Or municipality also will switch off the light in front of the house which has not paid, because just the opposite side house has paid. So on both side of the house there are on both side of the road there are houses. On the left side two persons did not pay, and on the right side, corresponding right side just opposite to those two people, they are they are not defaulted, they pay. So does it mean that two people do not pay and two people pays, or whatever may be the question, that municipality will switch off the lights? It cannot. It is non-excludable. You cannot exclude them. So is maybe non-rivalry. You are using the road. Does not mean that you are using the road. Does not mean I cannot use. So there's non-rivalry. Koi rivalry nahi hai. You are also using. You are taking your BMW. I am taking out my Maruti. You cannot say ki, you cannot bring your vehicle. That it creates problem for me. My vehicle is a bigger one. I need more space in the road. If you come, it creates congestion. You cannot do that. You cannot say that. There is a non-rivalry. So road is a public good, which is non-rivalry. There is monopoly. Water, we call it, water is a monopoly. Natural monopoly. That means there will be only one agency which will supply water, which is essentially in municipal areas, or in human settlements, we find it that it is either the municipality. In Indian case, it is either the municipality if it is town, or a Jal Board, and if it is village, it is the public health engineering department. You can have your own water supply as well. If you have in a gated community, you can have a borewell and you can take your water, that will not be considered as a public good. But when some public authority supplies the water, that water becomes a monopoly and there cannot be any competition in it. So that is also a feature of public good. So likewise, inefficient market. Market is very inefficient in the sense that unpredictable. You are putting up the, you have introduced public transport on a certain road with the expectation that you will have 100% occupancy. But to your utter surprise, you find that buses are running under, these are not getting the ridership that was expected of. Similarly, as far as water is concerned, you thought that if I produce water, if I supply water, and if I fix this much of rate, people will voluntarily will come, will register their DA and get that water connection. But you may find that people are not reluctant to take your water supply because they have already have their own water supply system. So the market is very inefficient, very unpredictable. And the usual average cost, marginal cost, those things which I will come to you later on because today these are not necessary. So that average cost pricing, marginal cost pricing, those things do not necessarily come in this picture, in this type of public good services, because you do not know what exactly what would be the cost of the marginal cost curve. What would be the you can do it for you means you are a producer of some. You means you as an individual, not as a public authority. You know the market. I'm sorry, not you. Even it is market when it is a market demand curve, market demand cost curve, market demand revenue curve, then it takes a shape which is more or less you know that these are the shapes it can take either of any of these shapes. I'm not saying that shape will be, it will be a S-shaped curve, it will be U-shaped curve, it could be V-shaped curve, but it will take a shape. And you can be somewhat certain that market, for this product, market will take this type of thing. But in case of public good, often we find that this does not happen because I do not know, because maybe the reason is that since market is not in the picture, you cannot read people's mind from the market the way you can read people's mind from the market. You cannot do it in a very straight checkered form. Just that I produce water, I start laying the lines, I fix this much of water price, and this is my cost, so this is how I shall recoup the cost, and people will be very happy to this thing. People will not, may not, sorry, I should not say will not, people may not. So under these uncertainties, most of these municipalities, they suffered because of these uncertainties. These uncertainties are not suffered by, when the same thing is done through through the market, but you cannot ask the market to come in because you cannot encourage competition in the provision of urban services. There cannot be a two water service. There cannot be three solid waste management service provider. There cannot be more than two. इसके लिए आपको physical infrastructure जो चाहिए. You cannot have two huge line for water pipe up dope, which is unlike your telephony, mobile telephony, where you can have n number of subscribers, because all they need is to lay the optic fiber, but that does not take that much of this thing. And moreover, the medium they use is I won't say infinite, but it is vast. They buy the spectrum and they wave, they buy and they through the they use that wave. But when water is there, it is so scarce. So how can you afford to have three more competition laga diya apne? So that we all know that competition will bring down the price or will stabilize the price. It will bring more efficiency, but you cannot take a bet on this competition as far as public services are concerned, especially the civic services are concerned, which are merit good, if not public good in all the various types. By type I mean that solid waste, sewerage, water, street light, road, footpath, all these things, bus stop, resting place, what you go on naming it. So your break-even point is therefore so necessary that you are entrusted with a water supply project, and your concern is that I must achieve the break-even output, because you will be credited with the break-even point output. Agar apne break-even point output kar liya, uske baad all you need to do is to just ensure that you sell more. So selling more means, mane once you achieve the break-even, uske baad आपका ये होगा कि मेरा ब्रेक इवन हो गया, अभी हम ज्यादा लोग को पानी देंगे, अभी हम ज्यादा लोग को अपने बस में राइडरशिप को बढ़ाएंगे थ्रू वेरियस मींस, इट कैन बी वेरियस मींस यू अडॉप्ट, उसके बाद इट कैन बी एनीथिंग, रेडीली इट्स नॉट कमिंग टू मी, यू थिंक ऑफ एनी अर्बन सर्विसेज व्हिच इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय एन इंस्टीट्यूशन प्रोवाइडेड अर्बन सर्विसेज. यू मे से सर आई विल गो टू अ स्पा. So that is not an urban, that is not a public institution provide public service. That is a private, there is a market determined private good. You may say, sir, will it also be taken care of by the market? Of course it will be taken care of by the market. There is so much of competition between different spa parlors. That they compete with each other. But you cannot afford, you cannot think of any competition under your area, that is water service. So you find out the break even, then you are satisfied, you will be credited with the job that has been entrusted to you for doing it nicely. So how do you do it? So we need three things. We need to know the price of the product. We need to know the total cost. Fixed cost of the product, and we need to know the variable cost of the product. Fixed cost means total fixed cost. Variable cost means average variable cost. Price means price. Average price कोई होता कुछ होता नहीं. Price means price. So, what is that? This is the formula that you use. F is your total fixed cost. F is your total fixed cost. S is your selling price or price or selling price, and V is your average variable cost. This don't take it as this thing. This I let me see whether I have any other. Oh, nahi hai. But please search the net. You will get number of. I have also some PDFs on break even. I can send it to you, but you can get it from the net. F means total fixed cost. Don't put it as F. Those who will put F, they cannot say ki sir aapka isme tha F. They will not get full marks. So it should be TFC, total fixed cost. S, selling price aap bol sakte hain. It is written selling price is okay. Minus variable cost nahi. This is average variable cost. Average variable cost. Because price is price per unit. And average variable cost is also average variable cost also means variable cost divided by total quantity. So it is also cost variable cost per unit of good. So your price is per unit of good. Your average variable cost is also your cost per unit of the good. And total fixed cost is total fixed cost. So 100 rupees is the total fixed cost. Your selling price is 10. Your average variable cost is 5. So how much water should you produce? You should produce 20 liters of water or 20 kiloliter of water, whatever it is. Because if the price is 5 rupees per kiloliter of water, then you need to produce 20 kiloliter of water to have a break even. Now, there should not be any ambiguity or there should not be any confusion here. Fish cost, हम लोगों ने बहुत अच्छा से देखा, fish cost is fixed cost. It doesn't mean whether we increase our production or decrease our production or we don't produce anything. Fish cost will be always, even at zero production, I have to incur the fish cost. Variable cost is something which will vary with the production. Zero variable cost when we don't produce, and it will go on increasing as we go on increasing the production. So total variable cost will increase, but the average variable cost will not take a increasing curve, shape of a line which is increasing. It will take the shape of a flattened U. I told you the reason. The reason is because of the law of variable proportion and laws of economies of scale. So this is why my V means average variable cost will be something, and my selling price will be something. Now somebody may tell that sir, selling or jo price jo hai, ye agar variable cost se zyada ho gaya, variable cost agar average price se zyada ho gaya, that it is impossible. It cannot be done. Then you are not this is no economics at all, because your price jo hai, in this price you have included both the price. Kaise hota hai? How do we fix the price? We fix the price on the basis of the cost. So us cost mein mera variable cost bhi hai aur mera kya bolte hain isko, total fixed cost bhi hai. So total fixed cost, why? Second, you may ask me, sir, agar aapne woh mein total fixed cost liya to yahan mein total variable cost kyun nahi liya? Why should I take total variable cost when my denominator is per unit thing? Why should I take total variable cost? I shall take average variable cost because my price is unit price. My variable cost is unit variable cost. So it is, when it is unit variable cost, that is the average variable cost. So your price, your average variable cost can never be more than your price. Anna? So you find out, so in the in your exam, most of what my experience tells me is that ki most of you find it nicely, you draw a curve, you draw it very nicely, you show everything, but ultimately what you do is that ye 100 maine jab 20 nikala, you say 20 rupees 20. Somebody writes rupees 20, somebody does not write anything. Very few student writes, that means 20 KL of water must be produced in order to reach the break even. So when someone writes like this, when someone draws like this, I cannot but have to give them full marks. But jab jo likhenge rupees 20, I'll just give them pass mark. I should give them zero, but zero acha nahi lagta, so chalo pass ho jaye. But that is not expected from your batch. You people appear to be very, I have seen your work in the studio, very agile, very intelligent. You are appears to be all good student, committed. So don't miss on these vital points, that break even point ka jo answer jo hoga, this will always be in terms of output. In this year only, I do not know which batch or which maybe plan, bachelor's groups may hoga. I do not, I can't remember. But some student found out the break even in terms of year. Now, how could it be terms of year? When I asked them, then they just got, they woke up and they realized the fault and they said, sorry, sir, it should be output. Because it was taught to them long, long back, they might have forgotten. So you don't forget. What we discussed today is that break-even point, which is way, which I believe if you are in the associated with municipal this thing, and you indirectly or directly you will be for any sort of production of urban services, whether it is water, whether it is transport, whether it is storage, all this where you can have a price. Sir, आप बोलेंगे सर कितना किलोमीटर रोड बनाएंगे ब्रेक इवन it is no point asking because you don't have a price attached to it. रोड के लिए कोई प्राइस हम नहीं देते हैं ऐसा. So this is not possible. So for those services, urban services, urban civic services, I should be more specific, or civic services or municipal services which have got a price attached to it, for which we incur a fixed cost and a variable cost, it will certainly have a break-even point of output. In order to find that output, all we need to do is to use a formula where in my numerator I have the total fixed cost and in my denominator I have the price. There is no such thing called selling price. I mean there is, but no point calling it selling price. Aap selling price bhi likh sakte hain, price bhi likh sakte hain, because many economists don't believe with the idea of selling price buying price. When I bought it at this and I sold it at this, when I bought it, that was not my buying price, that was the cost. So economists, there are many economists who argue that there cannot be any buying price. If you are buying something to sell something, then that buying is not your buying, that is the cost. So selling price are both set thing. I will not deduct your marks, but I would like you to write price per unit only. If I give you at all a question on these, then I shall write down those things, so you need not worry. And it is average variable cost minus average variable cost. So TFC divided by price minus average variable cost, whatever comes out from this division, that will be your break-even point output. Break-even output or break-even point output. And if I ask you to define break-even output, then you can go to the nets, find out, or you can do from this, write down from this, and you can use this this thing. You can draw it. Don't क्या बोलते हैं इसको, image को मत डालिए, that will not fetch any marks for you. If you can draw it in Google form, there are provisions for maybe. If there are no provisions, okay, you do it in a piece of paper and attach it with your form. That will serve the purpose. So this is break-even point. There's 9 minutes left. So I believe you have understood it. If you have not, then you tell me. So this is very important. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Achha. Very less students today. I do not take the roll call. I do not call the roll, but that does not mean that you should absent yourself. I don't know. The hangover of Diwali, so it was. Most students were there in the quantitative class. I don't know, but economics, why? आपको मैंने I told you in the first class. In my first meeting with you, that it is economy, equity, and environment. These three things will mold your entire approach to urban planning, environmental planning, transport planning. I throw it to you. Any one of you, or any two of you, or any group consisting of any number of students may just ask me, that sir, here is a case in transport planning, or here is a case in environmental planning, here is a case in urban regional planning, which do not require this three things together. So ये इकोनॉमिक्स को आप नजर अंदर कोई भी सब्जेक्ट को यू शुड नॉट अंडरमाइन. डेमोग्राफी a person who knows better demography can analyze, can do better planning, because population is at the core of your this thing. We do it for the people. I told you, whatever you do it for the people. You do not do it for anyone else. On my first lecture, I told all these things. Let us not be hypocrite to say, nay, sir, we do it for our environment, we do it for our water bodies. You do not do it for water bodies, for his water bodies' sake. You do it for your benefit. You plant trees for your benefit. You conserve the biodiversity for your benefit. So it is all your benefit. It is all you. So economics class or whatever class, GIS class, housing class, किसी class को ये मत कीजिए, because what I am sharing with you today, I mean, there may be, it's not that case, somebody may be ill or indisposed, there may be genuine reason for absent, being absent, but deliberately absent मत कीजिए, क्योंकि our teacher, each teacher, faculty, do not, I believe that, this is my belief, do not speak the same way he or she speaks, every student across the years. So the way I explain break-even point, I mean, some of my students are there here. I can say Diksha here, maybe other students are there. I'm sure they can observe that the way I discussed break-even when I taught it to them is totally different from the break-even that I explained today. If tomorrow I am to address a different batch of students, I shall speak differently. But differently does not mean that I shall deviate from the main this thing. I will tell you it is average cost divided by, those things will remain the same, but the I will digress, I will bring so many, I will give you so many examples, and because these are not, I am not looking at any PowerPoint, or this is not a set thing that I do, whether I am in the class in person or whether it is online. So you should not, it is not I, it is any faculty whose lecture you are attending, you should not miss it. Remember another thing also, which I keep telling my students, that each teacher wants him or her to be appreciated, because each teacher comes prepared for the class. No one wants to be, taken for a ride, or no one wants that since by the time she leaves or he leaves the classroom, everybody takes a deep breath and sigh of relief. Oh my God, gone. 1 hour was harrowing to us. So it may be harrowing. I'm not saying it is not harrowing. It could be harrowing. But I honestly believe, sincerely believe, and I do not want to dent my belief by anybody, even if it is otherwise, that each teacher comes to the class with a preparation, with the expectation that by the time she leaves, everybody appreciates. This is one. So you should, I'm not saying you should appreciate my class. What all I'm saying is that you should be present in the class in order to listen to the teacher, because I also believe that everybody changes their lecture. Their body language may be different, the way they teach, everything. The histrionics, that is, the way they, kuch natak, histrionics hota hai na, natak, jisko bolte hain. The dramatic way, which in better English, it is well known as histrionics, the way they teach. I mean, it is not what is taught. Some pundits say it is not what is taught. It is actually how it is taught that is more important. So, I mean, teaching is 99%. Ek baar maine bola, dekha tha, teaching is 99% histrionics and 1% academics. So, pata nahi, what this all to tell your other classmates who were absent today. I only keep my fingers crossed that those who are absent today, they are all absent because of some genuine reason, but not because of any health issue. I pray to God that nobody is ill, has fallen ill, because your exam is just 15 days from now, and you just one of you, whom should I ask? किसको देख रहा हूँ? नेहा, सत्येंद्र, मिताली, आदेश, दीक्षा, अपूर्व, तितली, सुरुचि, आई नो, और कोई नहीं है क्या? अच्छा, फाइन. सो आदेश, कैन यू हियर मी? आदेश कहाँ है? अच्छा, नेहा चलो के आदेश में भी मैं यस, आई डोंट नो व्हाट हैपेंड टू आदेश. He's just present. He just signed in and gone or what? Neha, you just, I give it to you. Neha, yes, can you hear me? Yeah. So you do me a favor. You just talk to your WhatsApp or mail or whatever way you contact the other N-1 students and tell them that 1724, which date do they prefer for a 25 marks internal assessment on economics and statistics on the same day? So, okay. I will buy time from the teachers, because on that day, I, Anjali, Arati, and Ashfaq, we take the class. So I'll take the class from Ashfaq. So 50-50, 100 minutes, you don't need 25 marks. I think hardly 60 minutes is sufficient. 60, 70 minutes is sufficient. I shall work it out how much time should be given. And similarly, in statistics class, but if you want, that sir, we would love to have it in the evening, in the afternoon, say from 3 to 5. That would be better for us. That is also possible. So you just 17 and 24, Neha will drop me a mail that, sir, we all would like to have the exam on 17th during the class hour or during 2, 3 p.m. to 5 p.m., whatever time. I shall take Neha's mail as the mail for the entire integrated planning student. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Fine. Thank you very much. In the next class, I hope to finish economics. And if next two class, I mean, next class will be on, next class kab hoga? Next class will be on 3rd. So by 3rd, I should finish. I mean, if at all it is needed that you need more time, if you all give me time, then I can finish by next Thursday, I can finish the entire course. Maybe I may request you to be there after post lunch so that we can finish the entire course, and I can tell you, I can make a recap, quick recap. I'll not explain everything. I'll make a quick recap so that you can write a better exam for economics as well as statistics. So we call it a day here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
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 Thank you, sir.